When Mazda debuted its CX-30 compact SUV for the 2020 model year, I drove this thing and thought to myself, wow, this is a really solid competitive offering from Mazda. And consumers seem to agree. This is Mazda's second best-selling vehicle, just behind the slightly larger CX-5 SUV. However, there was one common complaint that Mazda heard from its buyers, and that was they wanted more power. Now, that call for power struck me as rather odd, because with 186 horsepower and 186 pound-feet of torque on tap, the CX-30 was already the most powerful vehicle in its segment. Quicker and more powerful than the Subaru Crosstrek, or the Honda HR-V, or the Toyota CHR, or whatever. But Mazda says in its continual efforts to push up market, buyers are increasingly cross-shopping vehicles like the CX-30 and the CX-5 with Audis and BMWs. And in Audis and BMWs, they have turbocharged engines. So for 2021, Mazda is now offering this, the CX-30 Turbo. Now, there are some visual cues that give away that this is in fact a CX-30 Turbo rather than a regular CX-30, and it mainly comes in the form of the blackout treatment. Black 18-inch wheels, blacked out headlights, black mirror caps, not black, but chrome roof rails, and check out the Turbo badge in the back, as well as the slightly larger exhaust tips. The visual cues are a little bit subtle, I know, anyone can throw on some black wheels to a car, but that's because really the big story is the engine, and you can tell that's the big story because Mazda went to sort of insane efforts to preserve the CX-30 experience beyond that monster motor. Just how fanatical are we talking here? Well, according to Mazda, they tried their best to offset the slight weight gain of the turbocharged engine up front and retune the suspension very gently, so the end result feels exactly like the regular CX-30. I guess don't change what's not broke. Let's go over some hardware details. Under the hood is a 2.5-liter turbocharged four-cylinder engine, which produces 227 horsepower and 310 pound-feet of torque on 87 octane, and a massive 250 horsepower and 320 pound-feet of torque on premium fuel. Like the standard CX-30, it is paired to a 6-speed automatic transmission, and in this case, with the turbo model, all-wheel drive is standard. Now, interestingly, despite the massive jump in power and performance, after all, that is almost twice as much torque as the standard car, MPG numbers don't really seem to suffer. EPA ratings are 22 MPG city and 30 MPG freeway, which is pretty solid in the segment for an all-wheel drive compact SUV, and again, right in line with the BMW X2s and Audi Q3s of the world. What's interesting is that it makes more power than the base BMW X2. And I'm bringing that one up because it seems like Mazda particularly benchmarked that vehicle. If you look at sort of the stats of the CX-30 Turbo, it almost kind of slots right in the middle of the basic BMW X2 and the fire-breathing BMW X2 M35i. Wow, those names are getting really long and out of hand. Though here's the thing, Mazda's not after limit performance, because they know, like you and I know, that most people that drive these compact SUVs aren't tearing up the pavement and doing stoplight drag races or anything like that. So instead, they've sort of tuned the CX-30's powertrain for nice, predictable linearity as you press on the accelerator. They had this great expression that, because most people realistically don't mash the gas 100% of the way and kind of instead lean into it 50 or 60% of the way when they need to get somewhere, the sensation of having more power on tap because this engine is turbocharged, when you kind of squeeze the accelerator and kind of feel the turbocharger give you boost and kind of pull you forward, but still having a bit more left should you want it, they refer to it as power margin. And I like that way of thinking. It's clever, because as cool as it is to say your car does 0-60 in 5 seconds or whatever, realistically, no one actually does 0-60 on their day-to-day commute. Instead, you just sort of squeeze into the power, and when you feel the turbo kick in, it feels really punchy and responsive. Now, with these vehicles I get, I do try to test real-world fuel economy. However, because I only have the CX-30 for a day and a half, but after all, it's a brand new vehicle we're trying to get to as many people as possible, my EPA numbers are, well, I'm going to assume they're accurate. According to the trip computer, at least after driving 150 miles, I'm averaging 23 miles to the gallon, kind of right in the middle of the EPA estimates, and it's pretty fair considering I've been doing mostly city driving. I'll be really honest with you, when Mazda started announcing the fact it's putting this new 2.5 turbo engine in all of its cars, you know, the CX-5, CX-30, the Mazda 3, blah, 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 the list goes on, I was hesitant. In my experience, the naturally aspirated 2.5 engine has a lot of power and has solid performance. But I realized, again, people don't like to mash the gas, and that sensation of power this engine offers is really nice. The other sensation it really offers that the non-turbocharged engine does not is this sort of refinement. There's a lot of smoothness to this engine. It is like silky smooth. And because it doesn't have to rev hard to make a lot of power, the revs stay pretty low and the 6-speed automatic transmission usually stay a gear or two higher, and so it becomes a very quiet sensation, which is definitely a good thing because that is where the CX-30 really shines above its competition, is how refined this cabin is. Not only is it very quiet at freeway speeds, but the suspension tuning is excellent. Sure, it can be a bit tough over rough roads, but for the most part, it is supremely smooth. When you couple that with the quiet cabin and the pretty refined powertrain, this does feel like a luxury offering, full stop. This, to me, actually does drive and feel better than a basic BMW X2. The Q3, well, I'd say it's real close, which is definitely impressive for Mazda when you consider the pricing of the CX-30 Turbo. Now, the regular CX-30, I think, is a great value. It starts at right around 24 grand. Once you add all-wheel drive and some options, realistically, a CX-30, it's gonna be around, 27 grand once you throw some goodies at it. This turbo model has a $6,600 price premium over an otherwise standard CX-30 with all-wheel drive, which sounds like a lot. But again, it's sort of that jump that Mazda's looking for. With the regular CX-30, you are competing against things like the Subaru Crosstrek. With this CX-30 Turbo, it really does now compete with an Audi Q3 and a BMW X2. And with a $31,000 base price, and this test car is 35 grand almost fully loaded, though it's missing a few things, I'll touch on that in a second, it does notably undercut the cost of a base BMW X2. And keep in mind, a zero option BMW X2 with all-wheel drive has less power, less performance, and because it's a German car with no options, nothing inside to talk about. On the flip side, at 35 grand as tested, this CX-30 has almost every comfort and convenience one could ever want for. Leather seats, heated up front, heated steering wheel, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, 8.8-inch screen, which is pretty nice. All the driver aids, wow, there's so many. Head-up display, rear guided cruise control stop-and-go feature, rear cross traffic alert, rear cross traffic automatic collision braking. The backup camera in particular is excellent on this thing. If you hop into like a Toyota CHR, for example, that is garbage by comparison. With the CX-30 Turbo, at first I thought, wow, that's a really big jump, $6,600 for just the turbocharged engine. But once you start factoring in that it does include more things. It does have the exterior upgrades. It does come standard with better equipment than a basic CX-30 would. It's interesting. The non-turbo CX-30, I think, represents excellent value because it does feel so luxurious when you compare it against anything Japanese or Korean. This CX-30 Turbo also feels like great value, again, once you compare it with anything German. Regardless, at 35 grand, this is a very nicely equipped vehicle. The materials are really nice. Everything feels really solid in here. My only gripe is packaging options. Now, every manufacturer handles this differently. The one thing I wish is that Mazda does handle some things a la carte. While Bose audio is great and the audio system in this vehicle is fabulous, it is missing things I would kind of expect from a $35,000 luxury SUV at this price point. Wireless charging, standalone option. It's cheap at $220, but you'll have to haggle the dealer to get that thrown in. Little things like that where you're kind of like, well, why didn't they just include that in the first place? My real main gripe with the CX-30 Turbo is the same gripe I have with the regular CX-30, and that is sort of the practicality of it. While this is a compact SUV, and I do love sitting in the front two seats, the back seats are pretty much hopeless, unless your children are very young. I'm 6'1" with the driver's seat in my position, maybe even a bit closer than I'd like to be to the steering wheel, I straight up don't fit in the back at all. Which is weird because I honestly feel like there's more space in the back seat of a Mazda 3 than there is in the back seat of a CX-30. I don't get that, but that's just how it is. Mazda has done something really interesting here by offering this new turbocharged engine in much of its model lineup. You can almost now think of the CX-30 being divided into two separate models. Again, the regular CX-30 is a great value proposition. 25, 26 grand is a super nicely equipped vehicle. However, if you maybe come from an Infiniti or an Acura and you're kind of thinking to yourself, I might kind of buy that Audi Q3, it's looking really good. This is where Mazda kind of swoops in and takes the market share. Because wow, compared to a BMW X2 or an Audi Q3, this is so amazingly competitive at this price. I mean, you straight up cannot get into an X2 for 35 grand and you can hop into this pretty much fully loaded and have everything you'd ever want in a vehicle. So if you are a young go-getter looking for a crossover or small SUV and backseat space isn't of utmost importance, absolutely check out the CX-30. Again, I'm really impressed by what the standard car brings to the table, and if you have the extra scratch and want the extra performance, the added performance of the turbo engine is just really nice. There's minimal downsides if you can swing it. In any case, guys, my name is Jake Stump. You've been watching Drive, Brake, Fix, Repeat. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time where I go do more fun things with cars. Bye.